Hi, I'm Tom Lydon with ETF Trends here in Washington, D.C. at the Charles Schwab Institutional Conference. And I'm here with Matt Bartolini. He's head of Spider America's research at State Street Global Advisors. Great seeing you, Matt.
Great to be here, Tom.
Well, as you know, a lot of advisors are a little concerned about the Fed continuing to have their foot in the gas as far as hiking rates. Rising rates isn't that great for fixed income portfolios. What are some things advisors can think about?
Yeah, I mean, so we have three strategies I think advisors could implement. And the first one is sort of play the short game in bonds. And what that means is understand your maturity profile within the short duration space. So if you think about 1 to 3 year corporates, their yield duration profile is much more beneficial than 1 to 5 year because you're cutting out that 4 to 5 year bucket that doesn't really pay you much. So your yield duration profile is 3.2% for yield versus 3.4, and your duration is about a whole year less.
And when you look at corporates, especially high quality, compared to high yield, or even treasuries in a rising rate environment, long treasuries have, you know, some definite negative exposure. That's kind of a sweet spot, isn't it? That 1 to 3 year corporates?
So 1 to 3 year corporates, yeah. I mean, you're basically getting that 3% yield. You're very close to even what the ag is yielding. You're really not taking a lot of duration because you can get that roll down effect as corporations roll their maturities and roll their paper. That 1 to 3 year space does represent a sweet spot.
And what's the ticker for that ETF?
So SPSB.
SPSB, okay. Let's move on. You also think out of the norm for fixed income strategies. Give us an example.
Yeah, so we talked about the maturity profile for the first strategy. The other one is structure. And I think structure is really important when we think about floating rate notes. Floating rate notes are tethered to LIBOR, so they're going to adjust quarterly, and they're going to harness some of that rise in rates that the Fed is likely to continue to do all the way into mid of 2019.
And they're just another form of corporate debt, correct?
Correct. So there's some that are below investment grade. Those are usually referred to as senior loans. I'm talking about more of investment grade rated that are 1 to 5 year maturity. Basically, their spread risk is just a little bit over that of the ag, and it can actually provide benefits during a rising rate period because when their 2 year yield has risen since 2003, floating rate notes have had positive returns in 87% of those months.
And because they're readjusted every quarter, you don't have that duration risk?
Correct. So you basically get a yield of over 2.5% and a duration of 0.1 years because you're tethered to LIBOR plus a little bit of a spread. And the Fed has a high impact on short-term rates like LIBOR, so that yield's likely to continue to go higher. Meanwhile, your duration's going to stay the same at 0.1 years.
And what's the ticker symbol on that ETF?
So that is FLRN.
FLRN, FLRN. Okay, and finally, a lot of people are talking about going active is an advantage in these types of fixed income environments. Talk about that.
Yeah, so I think active management, fixed income, is one of those areas where active does work well from a core perspective. And I think in that short duration space, you can really target different areas of the credit curve as well as credit sectors to mix in with those interest rate sectors like treasuries, mortgages, and things along those lines. So it really gives you a more robust duration profile, but also that yield and diversification that is really beneficial in a period of rising rates.
And you have a relationship with Double Line that's a sub-advisor on your active strategy?
That's correct. So we have one that's core and broad-based and TOTL, but then we have another one that's focused just purely in a short duration space, which is STOT.
Excellent. Matt, great solutions, great seeing you as always.
Great, thanks, Tom.